Hello and welcome back to Koala Moon, a podcast of original children's bedtime stories and meditations designed to make bedtime a dream. Now it's time to meet our little ducky duo. This is The Lazy Duck's Rainy Day by Luke Prendergast. On a gentle bend of Sleepy River, which meanders its way slowly through Sleepy Forest, lived two young ducks. They had bright white feathers, golden beaks, and little yellow webbed feet. They were sisters, and their names were Bread and Butter. Bread and Butter lived in a nest made out of twigs and leaves, snuggled right down among the dense reeds that grew on the banks of the river. Anyone who happened to be walking along the riverside would no doubt spot Bread and Butter sailing up and down on the river, kicking their yellow webbed feet and quacking merrily at each other as they went. One early morning, Bread, who was the older of the two sisters, but only by a couple of minutes, was just waking up. There was a cool, silvery light breaking in through the roof twigs of their nest, and her sister Butter was still rousing herself out of sleep beside her. Bread stretched her wings wide, poked her head out of the top of her nest, and was delighted by what she saw. It was raining. Little droplets of rain fell from the sky, making their plip-plip-plop sound on the river water, like the tinkling notes of a xylophone. Water could be heard dripping from the leaves of the trees and pattering down like tiny little footsteps on the mulchy ground.
Butter, wake up!
Bread quacked for joy.
Wake up, wake up!
Butter, who often found that her sister didn't want to get moving in the morning, gave a big yawn.
Ooh, what is it? She said,
but Bread wouldn't tell her.
Just come and see, she quacked. Quickly!
Butter rubbed the sleep from her eyes, pulled herself up, and poked her head out of the nest like her sister did.
Oh, Bread! She quacked. What a day! Why didn't you tell me? It's a rainy day!
For the truth was, there was nothing that Bread and Butter enjoyed more than a lazy, rainy day on Sleepy River. While some creatures might not like the rain because it got their feet wet or their fur damp or splashed in their eyes, that was not the case for these two sisters. With their waxy feathers and flippery feet, ducks were in their element in the rain. They didn't say, "Water off a duck's back," for nothing, after all. As they ate their breakfast of toast and seeds, and pulled on their bright yellow bucket hats, Bread and Butter chatted about how they would spend their rainy day. They agreed that they would spend a lot of time floating up and down the river, enjoying the rain.
And we could make a big splash and have a water fight, suggested Bread,
who was the more energetic of the two sisters.
I'm not sure about that, replied Butter, who didn't really like to overexert herself very much at all.
I'd really like a lazy day. We can find a nice quiet corner in the rushes and just sit there, enjoying the drizzle.
Bread picked up her bright green umbrella, the most fashionable item she owned. One of the reasons she loved rainy days was because she got to take it out with her.
Well, she said, let's head out and see.
So the two sisters waddled out of their nest and hopped from its twiggy edges onto the gently drifting currents of the river.
Oh, isn't this wonderful?
Bread sighed as she felt the cool water running over her feathers.
Just the best kind of day,
Butter agreed. Bread and Butter floated down the river, enjoying the sound of the falling rain, which they thought was like a forest orchestra coming to life. Soon enough,
they reached an area where the river current slowed down and collected into a wide pool.
"Look what I can do," Bread said to her sister. "Are you watching? Are you sure?"
And when she was sure that Butter was watching, Bread took a big gulp of air and stuck her head underwater so that she was upside down, half submerged, with her little yellow feet flapping this way and that in the air. Butter couldn't help but let out a big quacking laugh. Her sister looked so funny upside down in the water. When Bread turned the right way round again, she shook her head so little droplets of water were flung in an arc and told Butter that now it was her turn.
"Go on," she encouraged her, "and make sure you flap your feet extra fast."
Butter took a big mouthful of air, counted to three, and stuck her head under the water. Now it was Bread's turn to laugh, looking at Butter's feet waving about in the air like that. And when Butter came back the right way round, the two sisters laughed and quacked together, because rainy days were so much fun. Then, to their great surprise, a sparkling orange and white koi carp stuck his head out of the water.
"Hello, my ducks," he said.
Bread and Butter flapped their wings in greeting.
"Oh, hello, Koji,"
they quacked, recognising their good friend.
"How are you on this rainy day?"
"Very fine, very fine," said Koji, the koi carp. "Can't be complaining, not with this glorious weather like this."
Bread and Butter looked up at the sky. They couldn't agree more. Koji, the koi carp, said that he had seen the two sisters ducking their heads under the water and had wondered if they were going for a dive.
"A dive?" repeated Bread curiously. "What do you mean?"
A dive, Koji explained, was when you kick down all the way beneath the water to see what was down below.
"There are some beautiful pebbles on the riverbed," he said. "I can show you if you like."
As far as Butter was concerned, diving sounded like quite a strenuous, energetic activity for what was supposed to be a very lazy, rainy day. But her sister's face was lit up with such bright joy at the prospect that she said,
"Okay, Koji, show us."
So Koji the koi carp showed the sisters that if they ducked their head under the water like they had before, and then kicked, kicked, kicked with their yellow-webbed feet, then they'd be able to swim down to the riverbed.
"Let's give it a go," he said.
The sisters, this time in unison, took a big gulp of air, ducked their heads under the surface of the water and kicked. What fun it was, Bread thought, as she propelled herself through the water, feeling its cool touch slipping over her feathers. Even Butter thought to herself, as she swam down, that diving was fairly exciting, even if it was a little like hard work. Koji showed them all the way down to the riverbed and pointed out plenty of pretty little stones, glittering black onyx, pink quartz, little white ones that looked like tiny eggs. Butter found a turquoise stone and a bright blue one that looked like a little piece of fallen sky, and she picked them up with her beak and slid them under her yellow bucket hat to keep them safe. They'd look very nice as decorations for the nest, she thought. Back at the surface, Bread and Butter thanked their friend Koji the koi carp for showing them what fun diving in the rain was.
"No problem, my ducks," said Koji,
before, with a swish of his long silvery tail, he swam away. Bread and Butter continued on down the sleepy river. Bread thanked Butter for going diving with her, and Butter told her it was no problem at all.
"What would you like to do now on this lazy, rainy day?"
Bread asked her sister. Butter twitched her beak thoughtfully
considering her options.
I think I'd like to go and perch in a tree, she said, and watch the rain falling into the river from above. Bread thought that sounded like a lovely plan, but she hoped that they wouldn't be doing it for too long, or else she might get bored. But she said to Butter, "What a wonderful idea!" And with a flap of their wings, the two ducks rose from the river and flew up through the falling rain until they came to rest on the branch of a big sycamore tree. They gave their feathers a flap to dispel the water, but just as they were folding them up on their backs, they heard a long, slow voice.
"Oh, hello," it said. "Welcome to my tree."
The sisters looked up along the branch and caught sight of their new companion. It was Fudge the sloth, and the reason they hadn't spotted her before was because she wasn't sitting on the tree branch. She was hanging below it.
"Oh, hello there," Bread said. "I hope we haven't disturbed you."
"We were only coming up here," Butter explained, "to sit quietly and contemplate the rain."
"Not at all," Fudge replied at length. "I always welcome company."
Bread was cocking her head at the sloth curiously. She wondered why she was always sounding like she was forgetting what she was saying, halfway through saying it.
"Why are you hanging upside down?" she asked.
"Oh," Fudge replied, "because I find that it's much more comfortable when you enjoy dozing like me to be off your feet rather than on them."
Butter, who also enjoyed dozing, had her interest piqued.
"Is that so?" she asked. "Why, yes," said the sloth. "If you don't believe me, you should try it."
"Okay then," quacked Butter. "I will."
And so Butter gripped the branch tightly with her yellow-webbed feet and, taking courage, swung around on the branch until she was hanging upside down.
"Well," yawned the sloth, "what do you think?"
Butter had to admit that, in fact, it was very comfortable indeed, and the world looked rather wondrous upside down. The river up above her, where the sky was supposed to be, and the blue-grey sky spread out below her, as though it were the ground. Best yet, the rain now seemed to fall upwards, shooting up from the sky below and landing in the river up above. How marvellous!
"You have to try this," Butter told Bread.
And so Bread grasped her feet around the sycamore branch and spun around to meet her sister.
"What do you think, Bread?" Butter asked.
"Well," said Butter,
"I have to say, it's more fun than I was expecting it to be."
The two sisters stayed hanging very peacefully off their branch, taking in slow, long drawn out words with the sloth and enjoying watching the world go by, upside down. But soon all the blood went to their heads and they began to feel a little bit dizzy.
"Time to carry on with our lazy rainy day, don't you think, Bread?"
Butter asked her sister.
"I couldn't agree more," Bread replied.
Both ducks swiveled round on their branches and, thanking the sloth ever so much for showing them just what a topsy-turvy world looked like, they took off from the sycamore branch and sailed gently through the falling rain, landing in two little splashes on Sleepy River. The day was getting on. Although the sun was hidden behind the big mushroom-like rain clouds, Bread and Butter could tell by the colour of the light that it was the afternoon. They had been having a very lazy day indeed. Soon they came to the part of the river where a beaver named Buck had recently built a dam. It was a very beautiful part of Sleepy Forest, with riverbanks covered in brightly coloured flowers and a nightingale who, when it wasn't raining, sang a sweet and melodious song that carried softly through the trees. This afternoon, Buck was relaxing on the veranda at the front of his dam. He was wearing a red and black plaid cap with big ear flaps. When he saw Bread and Butter come sailing around the river bend, he got up and leant over the balcony. "Howdy there, Bread and Butter," he called out, for they were old friends. "Taking a trip down the river on this fine and rainy day, are we?" Bread and Butter flapped their wings and said yes, indeed they were. "How about you both come up here and have a relax on my veranda? I can put the kettle on, we can have a cup of tea and a little something to eat."
"Oh, yes, please," said Bread.
"I am feeling rather peckish," said Butter, and all three of them laughed at her joke. Bread and Butter flapped their wings and rose into the air, alighting on the veranda of Buck's dam. It was a very impressive dam indeed, with intricate carvings and decorations. Buck had built it all himself, with his hammers and nails and his sharp front teeth. "Now," Buck said, while the two ducks got settled, "what shall I make you for lunch? How does some toast sound?"
"There's nothing I like more than a slice of toast," Bread told him.
"As long as there's plenty of butter," her sister added. Bread and Butter sank into the bean bags that Buck had lying out on his veranda. There they sat, watching the peaceful dripping of the drizzle, while inside they could hear the sound of a kettle boiling and the crunch of toast as it was cut with a knife. Soon enough, Buck came back out, balancing a tray on his paws. He handed the sisters a cup each and poured hot steaming tea from a perfect porcelain teapot into them. The teapot had a tea cozy on it that made it look like a duck, and the sisters quacked with laughter.
"Look, Butter," said Bread, "it's you."
"Oh no, Bread," said Butter, "I think it looks much more like you." Then Buck handed them a plate of richly buttered toast and an extra little jug with an unfamiliar liquid in it. Bread sniffed the jug. It smelled sweet.
"What's this?"
she asked.
"That," Buck replied, "is maple syrup. I made it myself from the sap I collected from the maple tree, right here in Sleepy Forest. Have a taste, it's a real treat." "Ah, there's really no way I prefer to spend a lazy day," Buck said, kicking back and taking a slurpy sip of his tea, "then having a warm cup of tea, a bite to eat, and some gentle conversation with some good friends, don't you think?" Bread and Butter said they agreed wholeheartedly. They told Buck about their day, about how they'd gone diving with Koji the koi carp, even though that was a little more energetic than Butter liked to be on a rainy day. And then, how they'd hung upside down in the sycamore tree with Fudge the sloth,
even though Bread was worried she might get a little bored. They agreed, however, that sitting there with Buck on his veranda, watching the rain fall slantingly and the river trickle past them beneath them, was the best of both worlds. It wasn't too demanding for Butter, but it was interesting enough to keep Bread from nodding off accidentally. It was, in a word, just perfect. They chatted merrily and watched the rain. They finished their tea and their buttered toast with maple syrup. Buck even went back inside to get a box of shortbread biscuits, which they nibbled over together.
"Thank you, Buck," Bread said. "You've been ever so generous and kind. I wish we had something to give you in return."
And just as Bread was saying this, Butter had an idea. "We do have something to give you," she said. And she took her yellow bucket hat off her head and tipped it upside down. From within tumbled the two beautiful pebbles she'd gathered from the riverbed, one of the deepest turquoise, the other such a bright blue, it looked like a little piece of the sky. "These are for you," Butter said to Buck, handing him the pebbles. "There'll be a pretty decoration for your dam." Buck took the pebbles in his paw, thanking the sisters over and over again. He was very touched by their gift.
"I know just where they'll go," he told them. "They'll look beautiful on my windowsill. Now," he added, "who'd like another cup of tea?"
And so Bread and Butter sat on Buck's veranda while he made another cup of tea. And when he came out, they talked about all kinds of things. They watched the clouds shift and change in the sky, turning deep purple as they filled up with rain, then bleaching a light mauve as they emptied their droplets all over the forest. They watched the sun sinking behind the clouds, turning the sky first a pale grey, then a dark indigo, and finally, black. Finally, Bread turned to her sister and said,
"Come on, Butter, it's our bedtime now."
"Oh, you're right," said Butter, yawning.
"It really is."
They thanked Buck again for his generous hospitality, and then they swam back up the sleepy river to where their snug home was nestled among the reeds. They took off their bucket hats and shook their wings dry. They brushed their beaks and pulled on some warm socks to sleep in. As they were nuzzling down into bed, Butter said to her sister, "That was the best rainy day we've ever had, don't you think?"
"Oh, yes," said Bread. "The best lazy rainy day ever."
They were both yawning now. For a lazy day, it had still been a pretty tiring one. "Good night, Bread," said Butter.
"Good night, Butter," said Bread.
And then the two ducks, sisters and best friends, closed their eyes and began to drift off. And little did they know it, but their final thoughts before sleep took them were the same. What, they wondered as they fell asleep, would the weather be like tomorrow?
We're drifting towards dreams now, the happiest, loveliest dreams you've ever dreamt. We're calm and cozy. Your breathing is relaxed, and you can feel that lovely weight of the blanket keeping you safe and warm. Aren't you comfy? You are so warm and cozy, so sleepy. As you drift into dreams, count all the things you're grateful for. Let yourself fill up with all of the little moments that made you smile today. See the faces of the people that made you laugh. Think of the things that challenged you. Think of the things you learned and the practice that meant you'll be a little bit better tomorrow than you were today. Think about how warm and cozy and sleepy you are here in your bed. What a day you had. Wonderful things lie ahead for you, too. You will have wonderful adventures tomorrow, and the next day, and the one after that. The whole world is waiting for you. But there's no rush. There's nothing more to do today. All that's left for today is rest. Deep, cozy sleep. The most beautiful of dreams are waiting for you now. That's why you're drifting off, gently, into dreamland. So keep breathing slowly. Let yourself get toasty warm. Let your eyelids stay heavy. And know that you are safe. Remember that you are smart. You are brave, you are kind, and you are loved. Think it to yourself. I am smart. I am brave. I am kind. I am loved. You are a dream. When tomorrow comes, you'll face it with a smile. Because you are smart, brave, kind, and loved. Because you are you. Uniquely, wonderfully you. What kind of dream are you drifting towards tonight? You can dream however you want, because your imagination is as wide as the universe. What will you find in tonight's dream? Maybe you'll see your favourite characters. Is that Hector and Sunny over there? Maybe you'll visit the moon, where there's mice eating cheese in the craters. Maybe you'll walk through Sleepy Forest, where Coco the koala is strumming his pink ukulele on the banks of Sleepy River. Let your imagination take you away. Your dreams are all yours, and you deserve the sweetest dreams of all. Because you are brave, you are kind, and you are loved. You are brave, you are kind, and you are loved. And you are wonderfully, uniquely you. You are a dream, and it's time to sleep, tucked up in your bed. Breathe slowly and melt into your bed. Isn't it warm? And soft and cozy. It's time to rest. Take deep breaths in and out and let yourself relax as you say goodbye to the day. Let your body get even heavier. Let your whole body go floppy. Drift deeper into sleep with every breath and say goodnight. Remember, tomorrow will be a good day because you have a big heart. You are a good friend. You believe in yourself. You know there's nothing better to be than yourself. It's okay to get things wrong. It's okay to ask for help. You can do whatever you set your mind to. Be proud to be different. Be proud of your achievements. Be proud of yourself. You are a good learner. You are a good listener. You are a good example to others. You are valued. You are loved. You are sleepy. So drift off now, little one. Let the dreams take over. As you sleep, let your dreams take you to magical lands and faraway places. Remember, there's no room for worries in your dreams, just magic. It's a magic place where anything can happen, anything you want. It's a place of positivity and light. Let positivity soak into you and fill you up. Imagine it as a golden light traveling from the tips of your toes to the top of your head. Imagine that wherever the light touches you fills with happiness. Imagine that the light makes you feel calm. You're wrapped in a warm, cozy glow within your soft, toasty blanket. Isn't that nice? You are safe, tucked up tight. So sleep soundly all through the night. Sweet dreams, little one. I'll see you soon.